I'm a product of the 60s. It was the sexual revolution, and I don't know anybody that didn't have premarital sex. It became personal immediately, thinking back as to what was going on in your life, etc. HIV was like a chameleon. Every day it had a different color. You really had to dig for information, correct information. But I looked up a lot of things because of my daughters. I probably had conversations with my daughters that most mothers wouldn't have had. I've always had gay friends. A very, very good friend of mine, very dear friend of mine, is HIV positive, and that's when it became really personal because we're just best friends. So it changes their lives so drastically that at a very young age they may find themselves without a partner for the rest of their life. That's sad. I'm not sure that the people living in Key West with HIV are fully aware of the people living outside of this community that don't have that financial aid, housing aid, don't have the help that they have. Society has more to do with stigma to me than an actual disease. The stigma can actually be the disease. You know what I mean? They continue to treat it like a gay disease. And that was a big mistake. That was a big mistake. I have three children, grown children. I have five grandchildren. I have one great-grandbaby, another one on the way. This should be considered like any other disease that belongs to all of us. It just, it's ours. Own it. I'm Fizz, and I'm that someone.